Good morning, friends, and happy New Year's Eve. Today is the last day of 2019. I hope I didn't screw that up and say that yesterday. Who knows? Well, I do know yesterday was the last Monday of the decade, the last Monday of 2019, the last Monday of the year. Maybe that's what I said. But today is the last Tuesday, the last full day of 2019, the last day of the decade. Wow. Can't believe that. And I never really like thought about it until everybody started talking about it being like the last of the decade. It's like, right. Oh my gosh, we're going into a whole new decade tomorrow. Unbelievable. And it's going to be 2020. Aha. I want to say, and this is 2020. I'm going to say that tonight. Funny me. I am drinking some tea. Out of my, what is this one? Mickey Through the Years mug that I got this past, I think I got it this past year, but it's got like all the different Mickeys on it. Absolutely love it. But yeah, I'm drinking some hot tea. I just had a piece of apple cinnamon brioche that I picked up yesterday at Walmart. Oh my God, it was so good. It was so perfect with my tea this morning. I've been watching like Good Morning America, and I've also been trying to keep up with, how sad, Brittany Boren Leach, her family and the loss of their 3-month-old little boy, Crew. Ever since last Wednesday, and I saw her post, I have been glued to Instagram, just keeping up with her story about Crew. I still don't know what happened or how he died or anything like that. I haven't read anything. I don't know if you guys have heard or anything, but yesterday was their final day with him, and they decided to donate his organs, which is such an amazing selfless, is that the right word? Selfless act. Yes. Very, I mean, it's just an amazing thing. I'm an organ donor too on my driver's license. So like if anything ever happened to me, I want, and all my organs are good, I want to be able to allow another person to live if they can, by my donation. So, and that's kind of what they did too. So she said 3 or 4 other babies are going to be able to live because of Crew. So Crew is just a little hero. So he is amazing. I'm sad for their loss, but he's going to live on in somebody else's like little body. Parts of him is going to live on. And yeah, my heart has just been broken over this because, I mean, she posted a little video yesterday on Instagram of Christmas morning of him like sitting in his little walker chair or whatever, and he was just smiling away, and they had no clue that in a few hours that he was going to be gone. It's devastating. So sad. So just for those of you who know of her through YouTube and Instagram or whatever, just remember to keep her family uplifted in your prayers and your thoughts in the next days, weeks, months, years to come, because they are going to be, they need it. They need it really, really bad. I know they had a GoFundMe page too set up somewhere, but anyway, yeah, just remember to keep the Boren Leach family in your thoughts and prayers, and little baby Crew. But anyway, today, Brian is at work for a couple of hours today. Yesterday he had a guy come in and measure for carpeting because they're getting new carpeting put in, which is going to be so nice. And he has another guy coming in today to do measuring as well. So he's kind of getting 2 quotes. excuse me. So he's going to be getting some new carpeting in his office, which is amazing. I'm so excited for him. It's going to be a great year for him. Everything's looking great with the company, so that's a good thing. Today, though, while he is gone, I am going to knock out some stuff, because usually when he's here, I get like nothing done, because he's such a distraction. in a good way, but also in a bad way. It's like he comes home right when like 90210 comes on and I can't like turn my TV on out there and do my thing around the house because he's like there. So while he's gone and it's only 8:20, I am going to knock out a few things. I have already knocked out a bunch of Christmas decorations. I still have my 3 trees. I still have some bigger things that I have to pack away. But for the most part, he's already put 5 totes away. I think I have 4 or 5 totes sitting out back on the patio, on the deck for him to take up when he gets home this afternoon. And then I have a ton of totes out here that I have to just pack up. So my goal today is to get as much as that stuff done. I need to change the sheets on my bed. Remember the other day I said I was going to do that? And I came home and didn't. But today I have got to. I'm gonna change the sheets on my bed. It's gonna be like an off day for me, but that's okay. I need to change the sheets. I said that down, what, 3 times? And put fresh ones on the bed. And just kind of get this house back to norm because it's just been like, ugh, chaotic and crazy. My bathroom is atrocious. I need to go in there and clean that. It's just like lots of things that have to be done that I've just kind of neglected, which happens over the holidays, especially when Brian's home, because I can't like focus on things when he's here, because not that he complains, because he doesn't, but it's just a lot easier for me to sit on the couch and just like veg and watch TV while he's here than it is for me to kind of get up and clean and do my thing. I tried to do that yesterday in my room and I'm just like, ugh, I don't want to like sit in there. I want to sit out there and do things. So I just kind of put Christmas stuff away here and there and vacuumed a little bit. I cleaned up the counter yesterday in the kitchen and put my new mixer out. But for the most part, that's what I'm going to be focusing on today. And then tonight, we have a New Year's Eve party that we are going to be going to here in the neighborhood, which is going to be so much fun. Brian and I were supposed to go to the liquor store and when he got home, but here's the thing. If we go to the liquor store when he gets home, that means I have to take a shower, I have to get myself ready, and I don't want to do all that right now. I want to focus on getting my house back together, and if I focus on having to go to the liquor store, then I'm not going to get any of that stuff done because I'm going to be in the shower getting myself ready and then waiting around for him to come here, and then I have to put stuff away, and then I'm going to be hot and sweaty, and I just don't want to deal with all that. So I told him, I said, just stop over at the liquor store on your way home and get what you need. And I said, and I'll be fine. I don't need anything. I'm all good. I was just going to get some amaretto so I could have my 70-year-old people drink, which is amaretto sours. I love those, but I've just been told that they are for like, 70-year-old people. I don't know. And I don't care. I love them. I can be 70 years old, that's fine. And I can like those drinks, that's fine. They're not like heavy. They're just real, like, I guess smooth. I don't know, but I love amaretto sours. Anyway, nonetheless, I'm not getting any of that stuff. I'll just either drink water or whatever they have available this evening. But everybody pretty much BYOB. Bring your own drinks too, and that's usually what everybody does, but sometimes they have stuff that they've made. So anyway, I'm not like a big heavy drinker anyway, so I'll just probably stick with my water. I always bring water down, but it should be fun. So yeah, New Year's Eve today, party this afternoon. We're gonna clean up. There was something else I wanted to mention as well, and I can't remember what it was. I haven't forgotten about doing Christmas cards. I will definitely do those. I'm going to tell you right now, more than likely, I'm probably going to do the Christmas cards and send those back out probably next week after everything settles down. It just depends on what I get done today in my house and Brian and I might go see a movie tomorrow on New Year's Day. We talked about meeting our friends for dinner tomorrow, so I'm not sure yet. So yeah, don't know, but for now, I've been talking for 10 minutes almost, and I'm going to go ahead and start getting busy around the house, and yeah, let's do a nice little New Year's Eve cleanup. Oh, I know what I wanted to do. I wanted to do like a year in review video, like total, like what I did this whole year type of thing, but let me say something to you. It is impossible to keep every single like video that I have done. Now, all of them are up on YouTube. Yeah. But they're very hard to keep on your computer and store them, because then your computer gets full and then you can't like put other like new content and new videos up on your computer. Yeah. I know I need to get one of those little thingies that I can do. But I told Brian yesterday, I'm like, you know what? I'm like, I really want a new computer this year. I said, a new computer, one that holds a lot more, whatever it holds. I'm not computer savvy, so I don't know what all that technical term stuff is. Oops, I'm spilling. That's why I don't drink, because I spill. Happy New Year. I told him I wanted a new computer, because that way I can at least try to store more footage and share it, because I would love to do like a end of the year video where I just kind of like put all my stuff that I did this year in one video. So like my trip to Disney that I took in March when Brian went with me, and then my 2-week trip to California, my road trip. That was such an amazing trip, you guys. I had so much fun on that 2-week trip. I mean, I got to go and do and see so many things in one like trip, because we drove and I got to see the Utah Salt Flats and San Francisco and Vegas, and I drove all the way from here to California and back. It's crazy. My son moved in with us, then he moved out 4 months later, which made me sad. Let's see, my other son Dalton got married, which, you know, I didn't get to experience that. What else? We went on a fantastic cruise. I went on an 8-day trip to Disney by myself. Got to stay in the freaking Polynesian. What? That was so much fun. I want to go back to Disney so bad. I might be looking at booking a trip in March. That's just between you and me, though. Between you and me. Please, don't say anything to anybody. I mean, that's just between you and me. I mean, it's Brian has a trip in Chicago to go to Chicago in March for business, and it's like a 4-day thing, and I'm like, bye, I'm going to Florida, bye. So when he goes to that, as soon as I know the dates, I'm gonna be booking my trip for that. Let's see, what else? So we went on a cruise and we went to Disney again, and then we went to Universal. We spent Thanksgiving with his cousin Danny, and I'm still talking and it's going on 12 minutes now. We spent Thanksgiving with his cousin Danny. I mean, what else did we do? Oh, I got a new air conditioner. I got a new hot water heater. I got a new refrigerator. Our septic tank was pumped and I had a mouse in my house. Happy New Year. So that like sums everything up in a year. Wow. Just a crazy year that we had. Oh, Brian bought the company. Brian is an owner of a company now. What? I mean, we have a business. This is craziness. A very successful business. So what are we looking forward to in the next year? Possibly new vehicles. Possibly a new, well, we know new vehicles. Possibly a new house. You just never know what can happen. We're going to Italy in May. May 27th is our leave date for Italy. And we're gonna be gone for 2 weeks. And then we have a possible other trip being planned right before Italy. I mean, we're talking like flying back from this other place and leaving, flying out to Italy almost like the same day. It just depends on how everything works out, but I'm not giving anything away because I don't know if that's going to happen yet. So I don't want to like say anything because I don't know. It's going to be pretty cool though if we can like pull that off. I want to go to Disney again, like I just said, March. My birthday's in March, so I always want to go in March. So even if it's not like on my birthday itself, it's in March, and I celebrate the whole freaking month of March for my birthday. I'm like, who doesn't, right? So anyway, I mean, who knows what else could happen this year for us. I mean, I'm hoping and praying that it's a great year, that it's a good year, that it's a successful year. Successful year, did I say successful year? Successful year. I pray for good health and just a good, safe year for everybody, for you guys, for all of us. I just want it to be a great 2020. We're going to be in the roaring 20s again. How exciting is that? I love that era, so it's kind of fun to think about, like, the roaring 20s. But yeah, I mean, we got a lot of things on our plate this year, a lot of things that I definitely know I want to go to the beach again. I definitely want to go to Pensacola. I want to spend some time at the beach. Love Margaritaville. I know Brian's parents are going to come sometime this year. Oh, I know we're going to be in Chicago in September sometime for a business trip for a whole week in September. We're going to be in Chicago, so I'm excited about that. My hometown. And then in February, Brian and I are going to Las Vegas, my wish. Nashville. So Nash Vegas. We're going to Nash Vegas in February for, I think, 4 days. I'm going to be meeting my friend Kim and her husband Sean for dinner one night. We're so excited about that. Can't wait to see her. What else? I don't know. You just never know with us. But I definitely have a few trips up my sleeve. And this is already 15 minutes of chit-chatting and talking. 15, 25, 26, 27. I'm going to go now. And I'm going to start getting busy. Or I could just sit here and talk all day long. Which I'm sure you guys would probably enjoy that as well. Right? You guys would enjoy that. So yeah. Let's get New Year's Eve started off with a bang. And let's get some stuff done around here. And yeah, Happy New Year's Eve, everybody. Let's have some fun. And I have already put out, let's see, 5 other totes. So this is where I have all my totes. I have them sitting on the back deck for now. And then when Brian comes home, he puts them up in the carport because that's where I store them. So if anybody's ever interested, I store all of my Christmas decor in totes like everybody does. I actually store my wreaths and stuff inside like a little wreath bag. I've got 4 of these. And then you can see the stairs right here. Brian takes them upstairs and this is where he stores all of our stuff. So these are some of the totes that I already have out here. And then these are the totes that I still have to put things in. All of these and those. And then he's been bringing, as I fill some up, he's been bringing some down. So the next couple of things that I have to do is I've gathered up all of my like snowmen and I've put them right here because those guys go in a certain little area, a certain bag. So I have to put those guys in there. And then of course I've been emptying my tree slowly, but this is what my tree looks like right now. All that stuff is gonna come down and get put in another like bag or tote or whatever, because I put that stuff away very carefully because that's my topper for my tree. I will leave like my red stuff out. So like this blanket I leave out all the time. This red wreath I'll leave out because it's Valentine's. I gotta take the Merry Christmas down. Let's see, I gotta take all the Christmas cards down. I put this red wreath up and took all the stuff down on the sides because of Valentine's. I have already put, taken all this stuff down. As you guys can see, it's just kind of a mess right here. I need to dust before I put everything back. I've put this back. This stuff needs to be dusted and put away. I need to take this wreath down, and then of course the Christmas tree in my room needs to come down. I'll need to change this blanket because I kind of leave everything red because of Valentine's Day. Everything in here has been taken down for the most part. The little houses and stuff I will probably place in different spots. But for the most part, all this stuff is down. I've been piling all of my like pictures and stuff that I use for Christmas right here. Pillows right there. I have to put that in like one of those little blue tote thingies. So I have all that taken care of. And for the kitchen, let's see. I have those ornaments that have to come down out of that jar. This Christmas tree up here that has to come down. And then these ones right here that have to come down. I've already started putting some of my stuff right there for Valentine's. I cleaned that all off. I need to dust it. I'll have to take this wreath down and put that away. I started taking the stuff down up there. You can see there's like an empty spots where I need to fill those spots in. And this is what the dining room table looks like now. It's just full of Christmas stuff and all the stuff that I have to pack away. So that is what I'm gonna be doing. These have a box that they go in, so I'll be putting those in a box. I have little snowmen. These things right here go in a box. So I'll put those in a box, and then I just have to wrap up all of my Ray Dunn stuff. This has a special box that it goes in because I don't want it to ever get ruined. This is something that Brian's aunt got me several years ago for Christmas. I absolutely love it. It is a very special like snowman to me. So his aunt Linda got this for me a couple years ago, and I absolutely love it. Pillows get put away, but I mean, for the most part, it's just like all the glassware that needs to be wrapped up and put away. So that's what I'm going to be working on. These wreaths have to come down and get put away. I've already taken down my garland here. I need to get these down and all that down. And then of course the wreaths, I've already put that wreath there. And then of course this is gonna get dusted and then like redone again. And then this Christmas tree's gotta go. So that for the most part is what I'm dealing with here. It seems like a lot, but really isn't a lot, because I've been really just kind of knocking it out of the park and getting it all taken care of. But yeah, it's just tiring. Because now that when I put everything away, I have to go back through and clean everything. So, and then go back upstairs and find stuff to put back out. So it's gonna be a process, but I'm getting it done, and that's all that matters, because I'm ready to just like have all the Christmas stuff done and put my stuff back to normal. Get back to normalcy, if you will. And then bring down all the Valentine's stuff, because that's what I'll be doing next, is all the Valentine's stuff. So yay! So I'm trucking along. I'll check back in with you guys a little bit later. Alrighty guys, so we are ready for our New Year's Eve party down at our neighbor's house. My hair looks a little like frizzy. I don't like that. But we are ready for our party, and I'm basically just wearing this top that I got at Nordstrom. I ordered it online from Nordstrom. It's just a really pretty like cold shoulder. It could probably go like both ways, but I just have like one strap off of my bra and I just have the other one up here. So yeah, I think it's gonna be cute. And just a pair of jeans on, then I'm gonna wear a pair of black flats, I think, or black boots, not sure yet. But I will figure that out before we leave. Brian's taking a shower, and then we are going to go. I have to go put my crab dip in my little dish, that way I can throw it in her oven when I get there. And yeah, that should be it. We should be good to go. So yeah, happy New Year's, guys. Let's go to a party and ring in the new year. We have like 9 minutes until the new year of 2020. We can say this is 2020. Just woke up from bed. We got home at 3 o'clock this morning and I took the makeup off and then we crawled in bed and Brian puked. So fun times. So anyway, yes, I still have my cough, and yes, I was gonna, somebody was asking me about an inhaler. Yes, I have an inhaler. Yes, we have breathing treatments. We've been totally all over the breathing treatments with albuterol. My inhaler is albuterol. So yeah, it's just something that I get every year around this time, and it lasts for about 6 weeks and then it eventually goes away. But I have my albuterol, I have my inhaler, so I've been doing all that stuff. So if it doesn't like go away within the next week, I will go to the doctor's, so, and just say, hey, albuterol is not working. So anyhow, and yes, I have asthma too, so that doesn't help. But anyway, and that's part of it. So it's very bronchial. Totally know that. So, anywho, we had a fun New Year's Eve party, obviously, at our neighbor's house. And obviously, like always, I just want to be respectful and I don't want to film anybody or share anything like with other people around, because other people don't, may not feel comfortable with it. So I'm always just very respectful, but I did want to make sure that I got like the countdown and of course then are going into the new year or whatever, because that's always fun. But anyhow, I am headed to the store right now. I am headed to Kroger really quick to, I don't know what this person's doing. Okay, driving through somebody's yard, thank you. I am headed to Kroger really quick to pick up ices for Brian. I forgot to get ices, which are those drinks, for Brian, because he loves those things. And then he wanted me to pick up some soups. So, looks like it's going to be obviously an indoor day for us today, because it is 40 degrees outside. And actually, oh, it says 46. I'm sorry. I saw this 6 and it looked like a 0. So,
46 degrees outside, and it's just gonna be a stay-at-home day, nice and chillaxing, and recouping from last night. I only had one of my drinks, which Brian did bring home my Amaretto stuff from the liquor store, so I only had like one of my drinks, and the rest of the time I drink water, and I had one Coke. That's all I had, and the rest of the time I was drinking water. So I'm good. But anyway, but everybody else was completely snorked. Hilarious. When everybody gets snockered there, they are so funny. But anyway, we had such an amazing time. It was just really fun bringing in the new year again with our friends and our neighbors. And his family, the guy's family that was there, freaking hilarious. So they were very, very entertaining. So that was really nice. Everybody was karaokeing and just having a really good time. So that was really fun. I probably would have been doing karaoke too had it not been for this cough, but because I was like so not with it with the whole karaoke thing when I have a cough. So, but anyhow, fun times had by all. I'm gonna grab myself a Starbucks inside of Kroger here, and I'm gonna get what I need, and then I'm gonna get home and chillax my whole day. I'm gonna try to get this video up and edited for you guys as well. So I just wanted to say thank you guys so much for hanging out with me, and Happy New Year, and I will see you guys in my next one. So Brian does go back to work tomorrow and Thursday. Oh, tomorrow. He does go back to work tomorrow and Friday, so he's got two full days back to work. Yes. So I could actually finally get some stuff done, but today I'll probably get some stuff done too. Like taking the tree down and that's all that stuff. So I'm at Kroger now, so I'm gonna go and I will see you guys later. Bye. Alrighty, so I just got back from the grocery store and I thought I'd go ahead and show you guys the very first grocery haul of 2020. You are welcome. I picked up some hamburger buns so we can make sloppy joes. I picked up some large tortilla shells because there's a recipe that I want to try that Jessica Braun had shared. Yes, I'm copying all the recipes from Jessica Braun because they look delicious. I got some tomato soup. We got some manwich mix so we can the sloppy joes. I picked up several different types of Progresso soups for me and for Brian. I picked up two more of these like sirloin steaks. These look so good. I can't wait to make those. I picked up whole wheat bread, white whole grain bread, all of Brian's ices that he likes. I picked up some peanut butter. I picked up some lemon juice. I picked up some Thai garlic sauce because I'm going to try to make some peanut sauce to put over some chicken that I want to make. I got Brian some Activia. We got syrup that's also for the peanut sauce. I want to try these new spatulas out with the silicone and the bamboo handles. So I got two of those, and then I got a set of just regular like silicone ones. So I'm going to give these a try and get rid of like all my other old plasticky ones. Let's see, some Dayquil, some of this Alka-Seltzer cough and cold, and then two things of clear gel, or clean and clear super gel, paracel gel, whatever. Makeup remover wipes, crunchy popcorn, popcorn shrimp, and then let's see, this is the peppered bacon that we absolutely love, and then two things of chicken, and then over here is some ground beef. Now I'm going to put all of this stuff away, and I'm gonna relax for the rest of the day. So, I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.